what is in name from NAFLD to MAFLD. Professor Mohamed هو بعت لنا المحاضرة مسجلة بس هو معانا أونلاين عشان الديسكشن.
Thank you, Professor Mohamed Eslam, for the invitation and nice introduction. So I was asked to talk today about the redefinition of fatty liver disease, the change from NAFLD to MAFLD. So just due to the time, I would try to touch base very quickly in five major aspects. What are the problems with the old terminology? How we came up with the new name and definition? How has this definition moved from a concept to a practice? And what are the aspects? So when we talk about the old terminology, NAFLD or non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, indeed there was a whole lot of problems with this term. In fact, it does not capture the heterogeneity of patient population with regard to disease drivers and modifiers. In other words, so NAFLD is like a basket when you exclude other liver disease. So it makes subjects with the steatosis due to metabolic dysfunction or due to other reasons. Hence, it's not surprising that there is a poor response and suboptimal performance for all of the drugs in clinical trials. The term non-alcoholic trivializes the problem, discriminates, and brings a whole lot of stigma with it. Finally, we need to think from a patient perspective and distance the disease from obesity and alcohol, and brings it more closer to other metabolic diseases like diabetes and cardiovascular disease. And trying to illustrate the concept of heterogeneity for our audience, if you take an example of three patients, in patient one, you can see here that the major driver of the disease seems to be environmental factors like unhealthy lifestyle choices with a minimal role of genetic factors. In a sharp contrast, patient three, the major driver is the genetic factors with a minimal contribution of the environmental factors. And patient two seems to be intermediate between these two. The concentration of this heterogeneity will have a serious impact into the performance of clinical trials and into management of our patients. From a public health perspective, we all know that liver disease is seriously underfunded, which is largely attributed to the current name of the disease, which is hard to be communicated and doesn't bring the sense of urgency. So here, for example, a study from Chef Lazarus in Barcelona in 29 European countries, none of them have any written strategies or action plan for NAFLD. NAFLD is not considered into the guideline of diabetes or other liver disease. Liver disease is seriously underfunded. So with all of that said, do you think NAFLD is the right name? It's a disease of exclusion, only exists when other diseases are excluded. We need to diagnose our disease based on a positive criteria to acknowledge that it can and it actually does coexist with other liver diseases. There is no safe limit of alcohol. The current name has a serious implication into patient awareness, public health responses, and underfunding. And finally, the one-size-fits-all phenotype seems to be inappropriate with the implications on clinical trials and management of our patients. So how we came up with the new name? We undertook a Delphi method in two stages. In the first one, experts from all over the world suggested whatever name they think. And in the second round, we voted into the top six. And as you can see here, that metabolic dysfunction associated fatty liver disease was supported by the vast majority, more than 72% of the participants. So what other things? It's just in a few months after the publication of the proposal of MAFLD, it has been endorsed by nearly all of the key societies, with the highest prevalence of MAFLD, including Abazir, Latin America, Middle East, Africa, Chinese, Spanish, Malaysian, and many others to mention. It has been supported by 3 Twitter polls, by the NERD and health leaders, by patient groups, leaders all over the world, which clearly suggests that it was the right time for the change. Okay, so we have a new name, but how can we diagnose this disease? So here we came up in a second publication by a simple algorithm, which is based on the diagnosis of hepatic steatosis with one of the 3 criteria, overweight or obesity, based on ethnic cutoff values, type 2 diabetes, and for lean or normal weight, they have to fulfill at least 2 of these metabolic abnormalities. So does this concept work into the real life? Indeed, multiple studies have shown that the new definition of fatty liver disease, including this one and more than 13,000 subjects from US, is more practical and can identify patients with significant fibrosis much better than the old. The same was confirmed in another cohort from Japan, where the MAFLD was superior than the old NAFLD and have higher sensitivity, higher negative predictive value. And now we have the similar evidence regarding to the hepatocellular carcinoma, chronic kidney disease, cardiovascular disease, even with other liver diseases like viral hepatitis, HIV. In all of this, there is a solid evidence now that the MAFLD criteria are more superior than the old criteria for diagnosis of the disease. And hence, the Abazir guideline have updated it, and it's published. You can find it's available online, which including the new criteria for diagnosis of MAFLD. What is the future aspect? So we all know that MAFLD is a multi-systemic disease, and it needs a multidisciplinary approach for management, which include the expert and the specialist from different aspects to provide the improved care for our patients. In addition, the new diagnostic criteria for MAFLD will help for undertaking novel clinical trial based on stratification of our patient and to choose the right treatment for the right patient. So in conclusion, MAFLD is a prevalent disease that affects 1 in 4 people globally. There was a numerous problems with the old terminology and definition of fatty liver disease. We came up with a new name using a consensus process and hopefully with a workable definition. We have got now an evidence for the superiority of the new definition compared to the old one. And more importantly, it brings our disease in a close camp with other metabolic diseases, including chronic kidney disease, cardiovascular diabetes, which means that for patient, clinician, researcher, the new definition will be very helpful. So our past is rich, our future looks bright, and the history of fatty liver disease is just beginning to be rewritten. And thank you for your attention.